Hey guys, Guitar Bookum here. Today we're gonna do Down on the Corner by CCR. And the great thing is, there were two guitar parts. There's the rhythm guitar part. Instantly recognizable. And there's of course the riff. So incredibly simple. Let's start with the rhythm though. In order to play this song, you only need three chords, but unfortunately, it's not the easy C chord we're gonna play here. It's a more difficult one. Then the F. And the same goes for the G. We're gonna have to play that G with a bar. Now before you say, well, to hell with this C chord, I'm just gonna play the simple C here. Well, there's a downside to that because this, combined with the strumming, doesn't really sound that great. Doesn't sound bad either, but compare it to... That's what we hear on the record. So you're gonna have to use this more difficult C chord. And if you have trouble with this one, some people just simply don't like those three fingers together. So you have the option of just using the ring finger instead. Now, for some reason, my hand and fingers don't like this sort of way of playing it, so I'm gonna stick with those three fingers, and if you can do it, then let's take a look at the strumming. Now, the most simple way to play it would be as follows. That's the pattern that we need to learn. Now, if you can do that, then there are two upstrums where you want to release pressure with the left hand. So you hear this. And there's this silence, two times. So that makes... If you play it a bit faster, it sounds a bit more like the Creedence. Almost like we hear on the record, except there are two strums we want to mute with the left hand and hear that percussive sound. So we're gonna have to do that on one down strum and also one up strum. Add that to the pattern and then we have... That's it, play it a bit faster. You can do that, then you're all set to play the verse. And on top of that, we have John Fogerty playing the riff. Now, I used to think, when I was young, trying to play this song, learning it by listening to the record, I thought he would play it like this. That certainly is the easiest way to play the riff, but when you look at footage of him playing the actual song, you can tell he's not doing that at all. Instead of playing that open A string, he's pressing down the fifth fret on the bottom string, so he plays it a little bit different. Also sounds slightly different from using that method. So we're gonna stick with what John Fogerty is doing, and when you play this riff, look at my finger. You don't see this curve. You don't want to play it like this. This is what beginners very often do. And that just puts way too much pressure on the wrist and the entire hand, so I'd rather have that index finger straight. Feels so much better. If you're able to play that, then you have no problems doing the next part, which is... Another thing is this thumb. You can clearly see it's sticking out the side of the fretboard. Don't do this. Yeah, I have the straight index finger. But you can't see my thumb, right? And that creates, again, way too much tension. By having a thumb right up here, I also mute the bottom string, so I don't have any unwanted noise. And it feels better. And then back to. So incredibly catchy and simple. It's one of those things where you wonder, why the hell didn't I think of that, right? Here's the entire riff. Believe it or not, we've already covered most of the entire song. Next up, we have the chorus, and in the chorus, we have John Fogerty, the lead guitar, playing a melody something like. You can actually hardly hear it on the record. It's very soft in the mix, and what I like to play is the rhythm guitar part whenever I play this song. So, starts on an F and it has the same rhythm pattern as before. What can be tricky though is this muted strum just before going to the C chord. You can tell while I'm doing that percussive muted strum, I actually go slide towards the C chord. It's one of those things you don't want to think about and it becomes way too complicated. And if it's too difficult, you can actually leave out the entire muted strum and it still sounds good. That works as well. Here's the chorus, rhythm guitar. Such a happy song to play on your guitar. Now, the thing that's left is, of course, the guitar solo. And there we have John Fogerty playing two guitars. We have one guitar playing. The regular riff. And on top of that, we have another guitar that's playing the same thing, but starting on a major third. Now, obviously, we can't play two guitars together at the same time, but we can sort of emulate what he's doing by playing it like. That's pretty cool. Let's play very slowly so you can see what I'm doing. You can tell I'm also sort of muting the bottom strings with the palm of my hand for that muted tone. And of course, just like in the verse, we need to play the same melody on top of the F chord, which in the guitar solo is. And of course, back to. Here's the guitar solo. And that's it. Those are all the parts we need to know in order to play the song. Let's play it together. Let's see if we can do it. During the verses, I'll be playing the lead guitar, the riff, and in the choruses, we're gonna play the rhythm guitar. You can find the tabs, as always, in the chord sheet on my Patreon site. Don't forget to pick them up. Grab your guitar. Here we go.